Hey guys, I'm Jesse here. In today's video, I'm showing you a quick look at Paul Braddock's latest creation, this Mandalorian Truth. So here is the finished prints. For those of you that have seen my other video, this was the Death Trooper helmet that Paul Braddock had created a handful, a year or more ago, and has now shared on numerous sites, including my Mini Factory, which you can go and download right now. I printed this on the CR10, I believe. I'm trying to remember which printer I exactly printed this on, and it came out wonderful, and I was really, really excited to get a notification that he has created a new file, this Mandalorian trophy. So as you can see, it has this really nice Boba Fett style helmet that is now battle damaged, and there is a skull underneath. So very, very brutal. All of his things seem to be very skull oriented. So Paul, we need to talk with you, I think. But this is a really, pretty straightforward print. I, as you saw in the video there, printed the base and the helmet first, and then went ahead and printed the range finder for the helmet. And the assembly, once you remove all of the supports, and I do have to say, removing the support materials from inside these little crevices, I did need to use some really tiny tools that I have available to me that made it a lot easier to pick those out. But there's a little piece here that's on the bottom that allows you to just slide this on top, just like so, and then you can insert the rangefinder. So it's a pretty simple piece here. It's a great little trophy piece, a great little display piece that you could have. I printed the default size for this as well. I obviously could have gone larger on the CR10, but I just really wanted to crank this printout and get it on display, and actually liked the size that it offered here. I don't necessarily need everything life size that I print. I'm very quickly running out of space in terms of where I'm gonna stick all of these things, but just thought this was a really cool design. Again, similar to this, I'm not 100% sure if I'm gonna end up painting this or not. And one thing I did notice with the print is I think I need to go into my CR10 and start tightening up things. I really haven't done any sort of updates to the machine since I originally got it and started printing it. I haven't gone in and tightened anything. I'm just noticing some more of the layer lines than I have previously, as well as some of the, it's like little zits that I'm seeing here. So I might need to just slightly adjust the Simplify 3D profile that I'm using. But overall, this came out great. I'm really, really happy with it. There are a few issue areas here, like on the bottom of the helmet. This just really did not print very nicely with the supports that it was sitting on, but how often is anybody gonna really look at the bottom of this? You're never really gonna notice it. Also, when I was removing the supports, if you decide to print one of these for yourself, you wanna make sure to be more careful than I was. When I was digging out the support pieces inside the crevices of the helmet, I ended up damaging this a little bit. So if I do end up painting this, I'm gonna need to repair it a little bit. But other than that, I mean, it turned out pretty nice. There's some overhang issues again here, but nothing too dreadful. It's overall, I think, is very, very cool piece, and actually sits very nicely in terms of the scale here with the Death Trooper helmet. So a very nice combination pair. Now I just need some sort of a pedestal for the Death Trooper helmet. So Paul, if you're watching this, which I hope you are, make sure to, I would love to have an updated version of this that includes some sort of pedestal. You've got a nice little system going here with these different helmets and skull battle damage variations of them. So very, very cool. Almost looks like a lightsaber was taken to this. Really freaking cool. But yeah, I just want to say thanks again to Paul for making and sharing these. If you're interested in printing your own, it's available over on My Mini Factory. It's myminifactory.com. Also, make sure to check out the links down below to Paul's Instagram, as well as any of the other social media links that I could dig up there and find. I just want to say thanks again for watching, you guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. Leave me some comments down below. Let me know what you think of this. If I should print one bigger. If you print one bigger, please let me know. I want to see that as well. But until next time, I'll see you guys later. But pretty badass.